Welcome to Pharmacology Insights, where we break down complex pharmacology into simple, easy-to-understand concepts. In today's video, we're discussing nipocalimab, a promising new therapy for generalized myasthenia gravis, a chronic autoimmune disease that affects the communication between nerves and muscles. Normally, nerves send signals to muscles via acetylcholine, a neurotransmitter that binds to receptors at the neuromuscular junction, triggering muscle contraction. In myasthenia gravis, the communication gets messed up. The body's immune system mistakenly produces antibodies that block or damage the receptors, thus disrupting nerve-muscle communication. Most of these harmful antibodies are a type called IgG, specifically IgG1 and IgG3, which play key roles in driving the disease. This causes fluctuating muscle weakness and fatigue that can severely impact daily lives. Nipocalimab is a fully human IgG1 monoclonal antibody. It targets a protein in the body called the neonatal Fc receptor, or FcRn. Normally, FcRn helps protect IgG antibodies from being broken down in the lysosome, keeping them in the bloodstream longer. Nipocalimab binds to FcRn with high affinity, blocking the recycling process. By doing so, it helps the body naturally break down and remove IgG antibodies, including the harmful ones involved in myasthenia gravis. This reduces the overall level of IgG in the blood without weakening the entire immune system, which is a major advantage over conventional treatments. In April 2025, the U.S. Food and Drug Administration approved nipocalimab for treating generalized myasthenia gravis in adults and in children aged 12 and older, who test positive for either anti-acetylcholine receptor or anti-muscle-specific kinase antibodies. This approval was based on results from the Phase 3 VIVACITY-MG3 study, a double-blind, placebo-controlled trial. In the study, half of the trial participants received nipocalimab alongside standard care, while the other half received placebo with standard care. The main goal of the study was to measure changes in patients' ability to carry out daily activities, using a scale called the Myasthenia Gravis Activities of Daily Living, or MGADL score. By weeks 22 to 24, patients given nipocalimab showed greater improvement, with a score reduction of -4.70 compared to -3.25 in the placebo group. This improvement meant that many patients regained important everyday functions, such as chewing, swallowing, speaking, and breathing. Another key measure, the quantitative myasthenia gravis or QMG score, also improved more in the nipocalimab group at -4.86. compared to only -2.05 in the placebo group. As for safety, nipocalimab was generally well tolerated. Most side effects were mild to moderate, and there were no significant differences between the treatment and placebo groups. In summary, nipocalimab is a first-in-class treatment that works by blocking FcRn, helping the body get rid of harmful antibodies linked to myasthenia gravis. It offers a promising new option for patients with targeted action and a favorable safety profile. And that's it for today's pharmacology video. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel for more pharmacology content.